Happy Friday, everybody. Max here with your fix of gaming news. Coming up, Microsoft reassures us that when Call of Duty Black Ops 6 launches on Game Pass this fall, it won't be hidden behind any special new tiers. The head of Take-Two has some hilariously vague words on the likeliness of GTA 6 coming to PC. And if you were hoping to play Little Nightmares 3 this fall, I have some bad news. Let's get into it. Earlier this week, Microsoft formally announced that this fall's Call of Duty Black Ops 6 will be available for Xbox Game Pass subscribers the same day it launches full price everywhere else. In a statement to Eurogamer, a Microsoft spokesperson clarified that no, this isn't some sneaky trick to get people to upgrade to some new unannounced Game Pass tier. Microsoft said, quote, upon launch, Call of Duty Black Ops 6 will be playable on Xbox and PC for Xbox Game Pass Ultimate, PC Game Pass, and Xbox Game Pass for console members, end quote. So that said, it doesn't rule out a price hike for those existing tiers. Game Pass did get a price increase last year, and subscription services don't usually get less expensive over time, so another one seems like a matter of when, not if. Xbox is betting pretty heavily on Black Ops 6 driving new Game Pass subscriptions, and it's a safe bet that it'll probably be one of, if not the best-selling games of the year. Black Ops 1, 2, 3, and Cold War all took the top spot in their respective release years, and Black Ops 4 would've if it didn't have Red Dead Redemption 2 to compete with. So Black Ops 6 sales numbers are gonna be interesting when you factor in Game Pass. Next year's Call of Duty will likely have its sales killstreak broken by Rockstar yet again, and Grand Theft Auto 6 is shaping up to be one of the biggest game launches in the history of the medium, and that's without launching on PC. But wait, it is coming to PC eventually, right? Well, maybe. At a TD Cowen conference this week, Take-Two CEO Strauss Zelnick was asked about the likeliness of a GTA 6 PC announcement and the present lack thereof, and VGC reports he gave this weird Schrodinger's cat paradox of an answer. He said, quote, well, the lack of an announcement is not something that could be set in stone, as near as I could tell, because the only thing that happens after the lack of an announcement is an announcement, I suppose, or a continuing lack of an announcement. I guess that could happen too. It doesn't seem to me that either would be set in stone. I'm not sure if the interviewer expected him to make the announcement right there, though CEOs have been known to just blurt stuff out on occasion, like last year when WB head David Zaslav casually spoiled that Mortal Kombat 1 was a thing that existed, and that it was also coming out later that year. Zelnick went on to dance around the issue, explaining, quote, Rockstar has an approach to platforms which we've seen before, and they will make more announcements in due time. I do believe that the right strategy for our business is to be where the consumer is, and historically, what this company has done is address consumers anywhere they are on any platform that makes sense over time. So Red Dead Redemption 2 launched on PC about a year after its console launch, and PC players had to wait about a year and a half for GTA 5. But with the rare exception of the first Red Dead Redemption, Rockstar's games usually do come to PC eventually. I feel like if there were no plans for a GTA 6 PC release, there would be official messaging to that effect. So it makes you wonder why they don't just come out and say it. GTA 6 is coming to new gen consoles in 2025 and PC eventually. So chill the fuck out already. It's gonna come to PC. I should probably note it's not officially coming to PC, but it really seems like it's coming to PC. Finally, speaking of games you'll have to wait until next year to play, Little Nightmares 3 just became one of them. Posted on the official Little Nightmares Twitter, the statement reads, quote, as much as we can't wait for you to return to the nowhere, we also want to make sure we give the game the care and love it deserves. Quality is a top priority for us, and we know you feel the same way. For this reason, we've made the decision to shift the release of the game to 2025. It's unclear if this would still be the case if developer Supermassive Games hadn't laid off 90 employees back in March 2024, but hopefully some extra time means that the team doesn't lose as much sleep and keeps Little Nightmares 3 development from being, well, too big of a nightmare. There's no specific release date quite yet, but we will keep you posted when we hear more. And that is your fix for Friday, March 31st, 2024. If you want to look ahead at the games coming out in the next month, go check out my roundup of June's biggest game releases, and make sure you tune in next week when IGN Live kicks off. I will see you then, maybe in person. Have a great weekend, everybody.